Good morning, starfish. Good morning, whales.
Good morning, whistlefish.
Thank you so much for coming to our performances today. In the first grade and I decided to perform a couple of stories that we had read during the course of the year. And these two stories were a couple of our favorites. So, the starfish class is going to begin by performing Miss Nelson is Missing, or actually, as we like to call it, Miss Barrios is Missing. And then,
I'm here.
She's here, but in the story, she's not. So, then, the whales class is going to continue with their performance of Where the Wild Things Are. So if you can stay in your spots, you will have two performances today. And thank you so much for taking time out of your day to come and enjoy this. And I'd also like to thank Ms. Barrios, Ms. Manzanares, Ms. Sofia, and Ms. Rodriguez for teaching the kids so much about reading that they are at the point that they can narrate the story themselves and they don't even need me. Can we give their teachers a round of applause? Starfish, are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay, do you see that there are people all the way back there? So we have to talk nice and loud and strong. Everybody ready to do that?
Yes.
Okay, well, Somina, I hope you will be ready. All right.
I'm going to step over here. Please begin.
The kids in the starfish class were misbehaving again.
That got talking and giggling.
They were playing on beans.
The starfish were the worst boarding class in the whole school.
Please quiet down now.
But the class won't quiet down. Class did as they were told.
They could see that Miss Viola Swamp was a real witch, and she was serious.
There will be no story time today.
What?
Keep quiet and stay still, or you will be sorry.
The kids in the starfish class went so far. Miss Barrios did not come back to school for days and days.
The kids missed her and decided to go to the police.
Later on, the detective Miss Mom was given the case. He and his partner listened to the kids' stories.
He asked his teenagers to listen to them.
It seems that Miss Barrios is missing.
Yes, it will seem that she's missing.
Thanks a lot for your help.
Some of the kids even went to Miss Barrios' house to look for her.
No one was home, but they did see Miss Viola Swamp walking down the street.
The class ran away quickly so she wouldn't see them.
The class sat down. down quickly and quietly.
Later on, when McBride's was walking home, she said to herself,
set the stage for Where the Wild Things Are. Are you comfortable? You're okay?
Yes.
Good. Whales class, are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. Just be careful with the forest, okay? Watch where you're going. Make sure that you don't bump into that, okay? You have all this space to move. All right. Whales, let's begin.
The nine men at the sea where the wolf suit had been missing of one kind and another. Their mother called them.
They are wild things.
And Max and Maxine said,
"We'll eat you up."
So they were sent to bed without eating anything.
That very night, Max and Maxine's room.
Tumbled by with a private boat.
For Max and Maxine.
And they sailed off through night and day.
And in and out of weeks and almost over a year.
To where the wild things are.
And when they came to the place where the wild things are, they roared their terrible roars. And they gnashed their terrible teeth.
Also their terrible eyes.
And so their terrible claws.
Until Max said, "Be still!"
And Maxine tamed them with the magic trick.
And they were frightened and called them
the most wild things of all.
And made them king and queen of all wild things.
Their terrible claws.
But Max
Thank you so much for coming. Can we please give the whales and the starfish a hand? Very short, I thought that you would be able to stay for two performances. I know a lot of you left work or you left whatever responsibilities you had to come. So I wanted to make it worth your time. And the kids also really love to watch their own classmates. And as you can see, they had ownership of the story. They didn't need me. They were able to do it on their own. But we've been practicing the story for almost 2 months. And so it took a lot of hard work. They understand what teamwork means in the theater, the positions on the stage, their vocal projection, how loud they have to speak, and how quiet they have to be. And that is something that even a lot of adults have difficulty doing in the theater. So I am extremely proud of these two groups, and I think they did an amazing job today. Finished because I didn't stop them at all. We finished earlier than I expected, so please feel free to take pictures. We have a few more minutes up here, so please take pictures of your kids on stage and have a wonderful day. Thank you so much.